Square walked into the clinic, Square wrote, realizing that like Ellis, Christopher Columbus, Dorothy, Galileo, and all the rest, he was writing an ending by living it, even if, like them, like everyone, he could never leave his book. But what kind of story was it that didn't have either a comedic union or a tragic separation? Pedestrian? Along one wall were clunky antique microscopes, their brass barrels gleaming dully within an oak museum-style display case. History or art now, not technology. The way that no one read Hippocrates anymore except as literature. Looking at the instruments, Square felt a tug of nostalgia for Leeuwenhoek's time when only a trickle of information could be teased out through the pinhole of an eyepiece, leaving whole seas beyond sailing. Deeper within the clinic, he knew, new biochips were being readied to extract from a drop of blood the typos that would eventually spell out cancer or consumption or other antique formations of some other flatland. An instantaneous palm reading of the entire body that made the two vials of blood technicians once took from Circle and the 2 weeks it took to read this tea seem absolutely Victorian. Like the thick glass lens Leeuwenhoek squinted through to see his face on spermatoza, the biochips would only give up what reflections the mind would let them, it being impossible for anyone to be from a time other than the time they were from, and Square felt his own body take on the function of the microscopes in the display case, passé except as philosophy. The way Heidegger says that only a broken hammer can call attention to its hammerness. If his story, or any art, was to compete with surgery, it was in this way, he realized. Square, a matronly nurse called. She led him into an office larger than he'd been in before. There's no place like home. There's no place like home, he told himself, even though he knew he'd never really been away. A medical table with stainless steel foot straps dominated. You're here for the procedure, she announced, looking at her clipboard. Disrobing to put on a paper gown, Square could hear his heart pound, like hearts did in novels. When he lay on the table, fluorescent lights shined in his eyes, one bulb flickering as sporadically as firelight. Then the doctor rushed in as doctors always did anymore, bounding from cubicle to cubicle like production line workers who assembled jets or other bodies too ponderous to move. How are we today? He said, snapping on an intercom in the wall. Before Square could answer, a spunky pop tune played. I think I love you, so what am I so afraid of? Oh, God, isn't this music awful? The doctor said. He opened a drawer and surgical knives jingled. I tried to put on Wagner as I work, but everybody in the office has different tastes, and we've only got one sound system. He laid out metal clamps and suture on a cloth, chattering, so we take turns, but anymore, it seems as if it's always the account manager's turn to pick.